Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. Welcome to this Microfocus Universe 2022. I'm very happy to have the opportunity to present the AccuCobalt GT roadmap. This is our agenda for this presentation: roadmap, Microfocus commitment to extend product line. We will have a look at which version you are using, and we will do, as requested, a quick review about what we did in the different releases of version 10. Then, for your pleasure, we will do a preview of Extend 10.5 and discuss about the Extend 10.5 beta program. Microfocus commitment to extend product line. Microfocus continue to invest in AccuCobalt GT product line, and we have recently increased our development resource. As it has been always the case for AccuCobalt, the AccuCobalt application written yesterday will continue to run on today's modern platform. The application maintained today will run on tomorrow's leading platforms, and the AccuCobalt application are ready for transformation to support today's business needs. This is the AccuCobalt version breakdown. Today, the majority of our customers are using version 10 and version 9, which are the supported versions. We have also customers who are using a mix of several versions of our product, version 8, 9, 10, with their different applications. And we still have customers running very, very old versions, such as version 2, 3, or 5. As requested, I will start with a quick review about what we did in the different releases of Extend 10. Extend 10 expanded and improved upon the major features of the previous version. This major release secures the future of AccuCobalt GT application for years to come. This release offers added value with the inclusion of AccuSQL and AccuBench products now provided as a standard component with the AccuCobalt GT product. It includes support for the most recent operating platforms, provide better diagnostic to resolve application fault faster, and optimization to boost application performance and a variety of enhancements. But most importantly, Extend 10 was the first step towards a comprehensive AccuCobalt GT modernization strategy. In version 10.1, we have introduced an instant user modernization solution, AccuToWeb, which allow our customer mobile, tablet, web, cloud deployments. We have also added brand new support for Unicode, for multinational application, faster application recovery and application performance with advanced file system tools, a print to PDF built-in capability, and also graphical and other enhancement. In 10.2, we have continued to enhance AccuToWeb. We have implemented all reminded control properties that were not in 10.1, and in order to allow you to deploy character-based applications using function key, we have implemented a virtual keyboard for mobile devices. Moreover, in version 10.2, sorry, it's possible to act on an individual graphical control on a screen. In the previous version, the customization was applied on all graphical controls of the same type for the entire screen. In addition, in 10.2, AccuToWeb was available on Unix platforms such as AX, HP, and Solaris. With version 10.2, it was possible to generate native code for Intel and AMD 64-bit processors. The speed improvement average is 3 times to up to 12 times faster, and it's applied on Windows, Linux, and Solaris. In terms of RDBMS integration, we have worked on our AccuFold GL technology, We have provided AQ4GL for MSS SQL Server on Linux. We have ported AQ4GL for ODBC on Linux and Unix, when previously it was only available on Windows platform. In 10.1, we have introduced a print-to-PDF built-in capability. In 10.2, we have introduced a new internal function in order to enhance it, $PDF. In 10.3, we have continued to invest in AQ2Web technology. We have introduced the .NET assembly support for Windows clients, enhanced the application network interruption management. Now, when there is a network cut, AQ2Web reconnects the user session. It's a great feature for our customer deploying in the cloud, for example. We have also added the ability to use JavaScript in the HTML5 pages. That allows our customer to use their own script on top of their AQ-COBOL application. We have enhanced the encryption for the URL generation, and we will continue to in this area because we got feedback from customers that they use vulnerability software in order to test their deployed solution. One of the challenges our customers have about AQ2Web is the fact that in order to modernize their screen, they need to know the CSS technology, Cascading Style Sheet. In 10.3, we have incorporated a CSS themed generator in order to help them to choose a style for their graphical control, even if they do not have a good knowledge of CSS. With 10.3, we have also completed the print-to-PDF extension. We have started with 10.1 and 10.2. And in this release, we have implemented all functions of the Libaru libraries in $PDF. It allows you to do what you want to do with PDF file. In 10.3, we have also implemented some graphical technology enhancements. Support for additional image types such as TIFF and PNG, support for bitmap scale on bitmap push button, increase Windows line and column, introduce the sort grid programmatically, provide a multi-line tool tips on push button. Those features help the customer using the graphical technology to modernize their screens, but also it removes limitation that helps user of AQ2Web to enhance the user interface. In 10.3, we release some data tools enhancements, AQ4GL for ODBC 64-bit on Windows, ODBC 3.0 support for AQXDBC, and AQ4GL for Oracle and MSQL server performance optimization for identity columns. We also added new platform support such as Windows Server 2019, OpenJDK, Oracle 19c. This is a list of 10.4 features. We have introduced the full JavaScript support for AQ2Web. We have implemented a new hidden screen control that can execute JavaScript code and can be controlled by the COBOL program. JavaScript, along HTML and CSS, is one of the core technologies of the web. Other 97% of the website use it. It has application programming interface, APIs, for working with whatever you want to work with it. Demos are following this session. We have also implemented a JSON parser in AQ-COBOL GT, allowing our customer to exchange JSON data. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. It's a lightweight data interchange format based on a subset of the JavaScript programming language. In Extend 10.4, we have added the support of the Windows 1252 code page in $XML. We have implemented the grid graphical control We have enhanced the grid graphical control in order for you to be able to hide and move columns in your application. Demo of that feature is following this session. We have added the support for loading .NET assemblies on the server side. You can now create .NET objects on the server when executing in a distributing environment such as the Sync client or AQ2M. We have also announced the CSS theme generators in order for you to create customized control. You can now specify ATW-CSS properties, which is either ATW-CSS class or ATW-CSS ID. We have also announced RMNet, the HTTP GET and HTTP PUT function calls have been added to support RESTful web services in RMNet. We have also added HTTP SET username, SET password, HTTP SET login, SET SSL version function calls in order to support HTTP servers that require a login. We already got a lot of great feedback from customers who really like and enjoy 10.4.0. Let's talk about AQ2M. In version 10.1, we have released a real innovative solution for our customer. When we say that we help our customer to bridge the old and the new, this is true. I mean, AQ2M really builds a bridge to the web and the cloud for AQ-able application. It helps our customer to modernize the user interface of their application. It helps them to deploy their application everywhere and so to increase their market share. We continue to collect feedback for you and invest in this solution. Using AQ2M, AQ-able customer can deploy their application on any platform, in any browser and on mobile with a customizable user interface. Here are some examples of customer application modernized with AQ2M. You can see on the top the before and on the bottom the after modernization screen. Release calendar. We have just released 10.4.1 and we will release 10.5 in November 2022. You can see here some new features. I will give you more detail about these new features in the following slides. There are several grid control enhancements in this release. Adjustable rows. This style enables the adjustment of row height by dragging row dividers using the mouse, as you can see in this screen. Row height, this property sets the height of row in the grid. We have also added center row headings. This style, when enabled, vertically aligns vertically centers the grid row headings. This style is set when declaring the grid in the screen section. We have also added V alignment. This property sets the vertical alignment of text within the targeted cell. Accepted value for it are T, top aligned, B, bottom aligned, C, vertically center aligned, U, unaligned. We have also added a property, wrap text. This property enables or disables text wrapping within a cell. Also, following the new features in 10.4, with the ability to hide and to move columns in a grid, we have implemented a new property, physical X, that can be inquired and will return the physical column active during a current event. New browser control. With Microsoft deprecating Internet Explorer, we needed a new browser control to replace the current web browser. Note that the original web browser control is still available to use. The new control type is named Web Browser 2 and implements the Microsoft Edge browser. You can see on this screenshot on the right side that the old browser control say it isn't supported anymore. On the left side, you have the new browser control. There is a new active background property for entry fields. Setting these properties will cause the entry field background color to change upon becoming active. The background color reverts when the field is no longer active. AQ2Web Desktop Auto Updates. The AQ2Web Desktop has no automatic update features that determines whether the AQ2Web Desktop executable on the client is compatible with the server component. If the AQ2Web Desktop executable version that is stored in the server is newer than the running one on the client machine, the update process will be triggered. For version prior to 10.5, we leave it as it is now. User will get the notification about the new AQ2Web Desktop setup. He will download it by accepting the download and install it manually. For version 10.5 and above, we will have the implementation in the new AQ2Web Desktop for automatic installation. URL redirection when a program is closed. So when a program is closed or when the site closes because of inactivity, the default is to go to a blank page or just close the tab. It is not possible in 10.5 with the new configuration option, custom return, to redirect all your alias with custom return default and equal link like in this example, or to redirect a specific alias. In this case, you know, we have custom return my alias equal and a link. We have also announced the security to prevent code injection in the HTML pages in AQ2Web. And also for the AQ2Web Gateway service, we now use TOML format for the configuration files. We do migrate from current configuration syntax into TOML config file with a TOML extension, while still supporting the current config file syntax. When using a conf file to start the service, the file will be converted automatically into a TOML configuration file and save next to the original configuration file in the same directory. TOML format is easy to read and includes a formal specification. Automatic global Windows resize and browser Windows resize. So in 10.5, it will be possible to display the entire screen of an application, whatever the resolution of the screen is. When today, when you decrease the size of the browser, the COBOL screen is truncated. In 10.5, we have added the support for COBOL deployment into Docker containers. Starting with this release, sample has been added to enable you to work with image containers. These samples show you how to run a COBOL program in a container using AQSIN and AQ2Web. These samples are available for Windows and Linux platform. You will see a demo of it later after this presentation. 10.5, with 10.5, AQCOBOL GT Dev 6, including AQBench and other executable, are now available as 64-bit binaries. It also includes the Sync Client 64-bit. In 10.5, we have also completed our JSON parser implementation. We have added support for the suppress when phrase to the JSON generate verb. It allows the suppression of data items in the generate JSON data if they contain certain value. We have also added support for the JSON parse and generate name omitted. This feature allows the parsing of generating of JSON while omitting the name of the top-level COBOL group items. In 10.5, we have also introduced two new library functions for converting strings between ISO 8859-15 and UTF-8 encoding and vice versa. It allows our customer to encode also the euro currency symbol available in ISO 8859-15. There is also a new standard library routine $shell execute. This routine emulates the shell execute exe Win32 API function, which is what is executed when a user double clicks on an icon in Windows Explorer. We have used the third party library for loading graphics file, BNP, JPEG, PNG, TIFF, but this library has dropped out of support by its vendor. We now use the Microsoft ETL MFC class C image to load these file types. This makes our bitmap support much better in a lot of ways, including handling the transparent property and stretching to fit. Now the bitmap WBitmap capture operation code, image, desktop, clipboard, all now support writing different image types, including BMP, JPEG, PNG, and TIFF. We have also included in 10.5 the ability to trace events that are generated by the runtime to execute event paragraphs and before after exception procedure. From within the runtime debugger, you have to execute the command TE to toggle event tracing, which will be sent to the error file. In this release, we have added the support for line sequential file for AQXDBC. There is a new XFD value for file organization, line sequential. And 10.5 will be the first version to officially support Windows 11. Extend 10.5 beta program. We will organize an extend beta program by the end of August 2022. Your participation in this program will enable you to receive an early access to the next generation of AQCobol technology, providing you with more time to plan your own release cycles. We'll enable you to provide direct input into the design and functionality of the AQ product we offer. Enable you to ensure that your application are compatible with the newest Extend release. Enable you to improve Extend product quality and usability by reporting any anomalies during testing. Enable you to become recognized as a proven beta program participant and receive priority access in future beta program offering. Please contact your account manager or myself if you want to participate in this program. Beyond 10.5, we are gathering information now. Like for the beta program, you have the opportunity to provide direct input into the design and functionality of the AQ product we offer. Your contributions are of high value to us, and we will use the information provided to inform and shape the future Extend product roadmap. Thanks a lot.